Hi guys, Nick Jennison, Big Guitar Interactive, and today we're taking a look at this lovely GPC-13E from our friends at Martin. This guitar is part of their Rhodes series, which is very much aimed at the working musician. It's a fabulous instrument that sits at the more affordable end of Martin's price spectrum. It's still quite a serious investment because it is still a very serious instrument, but it's made of some ecologically friendly woods that we'll talk about in a moment. A quick word on how we're going to do this review. In the intro, you heard me playing some fingerstyle lines with some percussive elements, and we're flipping between the onboard pickup system and the microphone. That's the only time you're going to hear the mic in this particular review, and the reason for this is that this particular guitar and this series of guitars is very much designed for the performing guitarist. So we're going to focus on the plugged-in sound because that's how this guitar, to my mind, is going to be used by most of you out there. But if you want to hear a little bit more of the mic'd up sound, you can go back to that intro jam and flip between the two so you can get a good measure of how it compares to the plugged in sound. Before we go any further and talk about any specs or any of that kind of business, let's take a listen to some single note lines played with a pick. So now that we've heard the guitar with both pick and fingers, let's talk about some spec, starting at the headstock. So the first thing that strikes me looking at the headstock is this classic Martin logo on a very timeless looking and unfussy peghead with three in a row tuners, as you'd expect if we turn things over. Once again, we'll see those tuners, the Martin branded tuners. There's nothing fancy going on here with open gears or locking anything. It's just standard, reliable, solid feeling tuners. The neck itself is a one piece neck with no scarf jointing to speak of, and it's Martin's performing artist profile with the high performance taper. Now, if I turn it back over, I'm going to show you the fingerboard, which is a rich light fingerboard. And of course, the neck profile itself, which I haven't talked to you about yet, is an asymmetrical profile. So there's actually more size on the neck towards the treble side and a little bit slimmer of a profile towards the bass strings. Now, what this means is that your thumb is going to be very, very comfortable both behind and over the top of the neck. But there's also plenty of meat on the bottom of the neck to support your hand if you tend to rest your first finger against the bottom edge of the fretboard. But it also means, again, if you're a thumb over type player, there's not too much neck wood to fill this part of your hand if perhaps you don't have the largest of hands. Now, I've got pretty long fingers, so I can kind of get away with this on most guitars, but it's a really comfortable feeling neck. Now, if we turn our attention to the body, we've got a 14th fret body joint. And the back and sides, I'm going to tell you about this now because we're talking about the ecologically friendly woods that this guitar is made of. This is, and I'm probably going to butcher this pronunciation, this back and sides are made of solid mutenye. Now, you'll have to forgive me, I'm not 100% sure how to pronounce this, but it's an African wood that is very close to both rosewood and ovencoal. And because of this, you can expect a warm, thick low end with a slight dip in the mid-range. It's not going to be that kind of punchy mahogany sound. And there's also a very sparkly, silky treble. So again, it's not bright like maple, it's more of a silky, extended kind of top end, and it has that very breathy low end. Turning back over, we have a solid Sitka spruce top, which is standard on the Road series from Martin, and it's a really welcome addition. It does make a huge difference. The top of your guitar is massive to the tone, and it's an X-brace pattern with a scallop bracing, although it feels like it's braced quite stiffly. Feels like it's built more for sustain than for projection, which comes in handy when you plug things in. Of course, the body style is Martin's Grand Performance body, which is a slightly smaller, it's kind of like a concert size guitar, which is very, very comfortable. It's reasonably thick, it wouldn't call it a parlor type shape, but it's really comfy if you're not into massive hulking dreadnought guitars, which for me is absolutely ideal. Now, speaking of plugging in, the pickup system, and I'm going to show you this tuner here, which is really rather cool, because there is a little tuner inside the sound hole. Hopefully you can see that. And this is part of Fishman's MXT pickup system. Now, it's a very unintrusive system. There's simply a tone and a volume control tucked away inside the sound hole, so there are no holes cut into the top bout of your guitar, and it plugs in down here, right by the bridge pin. Now, the upshot of this means that we don't have to cut a huge amount of wood out of the side of your guitar to fit your pickup system, and that means it's going to have a very low impact on the unplugged tone of your guitar. Now, the pickup system itself sounds very, very natural and very warm, and there's not a huge amount of adjustment, but I think that's a good thing because I've never been a fan of those kind of big 3-4 slider EQ type systems. It just puts too much control in the hands of the guitarist for my money, when really that's the sort of thing that you should leave to your front of house engineer. So speaking of pickup systems, let's take another listen to it, and this time we're going to strum some chords with a slimmer plectrum. So hopefully what you can hear from that is that the dynamic range of this pickup system is not excessive, but it's certainly very, very open, and you can really express with your strumming hand and with your picking hand pressure, but it's not excessively dynamic to the point where loud strums are going to kind of poke you in the head metaphorically and quieter strums will disappear into the mix. It's a very natural playing experience. Another cool thing to note is that if you're resting on the bridge, there's no notable noise as you brush your hand across the bridge pins. Now, this can be a problem on some piezo type systems and can result in excessive noise, but there's none of that with this particular setup right now. Now, one very good test in my experience for how natural a pickup system sounds is playing slide, because it can really sound abrasive and nasty, especially if you use a heavy brass slide, if your pickup system is less than optimal. However, the Fishman MXT on board this particular guitar sounds wonderful for this kind of application. So we're going to try some of that now. Thank you. So for this kind of playing, the pickup system works with you rather than working against you, which is wonderful. I should emphasize that you're listening to the pickup sound with no additional EQ or compression, just a splash of reverb that we've added in post, and it does a lot to mask some of the rattle and clatter that's inherent in slide guitar playing, as opposed to emphasizing it, which some pickup systems can do. It's a wonderful thing, and it, of course, again, it emphasizes the long sustain and rich even tone that this guitar provides. It's a really wonderful playing experience. So anyway guys, I'm gonna leave you there. This is the Martin GPC-13E. My name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive and I will see you next time. Check out these links here for more great content. We are, of course, your home for all things gear related, and we have killer interviews and tuition and all manner of stuff coming up for you in the near future. So hit that subscribe button down there. Make sure you hit the notification icon too, so we can keep you up to date with the latest and greatest news on all things guitar.